Hi guys, this is your sister Karen Gideon in Jesus Christ. Guys, I just want to come to you with a revelation that God has revealed to me the beginning of this week. What date are we on today? We're on the 12th of June, so probably backtrack, so probably to about the 7th or something like that. 7th or 8th, God revealed a revelation to me, which obviously when God gives me a revelation, I don't keep it to myself, brothers and sisters. I share it, whether people accept it or not. I put it up there, and it's the Holy Spirit who does the conviction. But just before I go into the revelation that God gave me, the Lord was reminding me of a particular vision where I saw a huge serpent fell from the sky. This vision was in 2016, and I've actually shared it on my Facebook post, but I don't think I've done a video concerning this vision. But briefly, with this vision, brothers and sisters, I saw the angels of God fighting the fallen angel. It was like their bodies were so big in this vision. They were standing on the earth and the light reached almost up to the sun. That is to show you how huge these beings were. And I saw them fighting. Now, obviously, I saw them with swords and shield fighting, but obviously when God's angel and the fallen angels will fight, when Satan will be kicked out of heaven, we don't know if it's sword or if it's word of mouth, we don't know. But obviously I saw them with the sword, which represent fighting, and as they began to fight, obviously the angels of God won, and I saw these beings begin to fall from heaven, brothers and sisters, and they all had wings. Every single one of them that fell had wings, and I saw some fell in the river, some fell in trees, some fell near caves, all over the place dotted. And as that began to happen, I then saw a huge serpent, massive snake, brothers and sisters, fell from the sky with such a huge force, the earth rippled. And when he fell from the sky, the angel of God came down and he began to speak to me, and he said he's going to put a tree over the serpent to bar him so that he doesn't get up. So the angel of God used a massive tree and put over the serpent, and he was barred. Nobody could move this tree, brothers and sisters, don't matter how they try. And the serpent was wriggling around, and all of a sudden the serpent began to speak. And I was in awe because, you know, obviously this is a snake, but it was speaking. And it said, go and kill all the Hebrew children. Now, when I got that vision in 2016, I had no knowledge whatsoever concerning the children of Israel or the children of Jacob being scattered, because in my mind, even though God began to wake me up, even before the Lord woke me up, I thought that the 12 tribes of Jacob has died out, that you cannot find them anywhere at all in the world, the non-existence. But that was my belief. And even when I had this vision in 2016, and when Satan said, go kill all the Hebrew children, and I posted this on my Facebook page, not a lot of people commented on the Hebrew part, but they commented on the snake being trapped with a tree by the angel of God. So as the Lord brought that vision back to my remembrance, brothers and sisters, this is where the revelation came in. So I was sent to the Lord, okay, Satan said, go and get my Hebrew children, go and kill all the Hebrew children. Then all of a sudden, brothers and sisters, the Holy Spirit began to speak, and he said to me, the tribe of Dan is in 80. So when I heard that, obviously I went like that, okay. I said, Lord, what did you say? And he repeated it again. He said, the tribe of Dan is in 80. And I said, Lord, please help me to understand what you're saying to me. The tribe of Dan is in Haiti. Then the Lord began to speak and download in my spirit. And he brought me to Genesis 49, where Jacob gave the blessing on his 12 sons. And Dan, when he blessed Dan, there was three part to Dan's blessing. The first part, that Dan will be the ruler over his people. That's the first part. And then the second part, that Dan will go in the way of the serpent. And that's the second part. And then the third part of the blessing is that Dan will find God again, because it says, oh God, you are my salvation. And I did a little research, and I realized that the first part of Dan, the first part of what Jacob said concerning the blessing of Dan, has been fulfilled. Because I didn't realize that Samson's dad was from the tribe of Dan. He's a Danite, so obviously Samson is from the tribe of Dan. And that part has been fulfilled, because Samson ruled the children of Israel for 20 or 25 years, something like that. So that part is fulfilled. So the second part, where Jacob said Dan, the descendant of Dan, that tribe will go in the way of the serpent, which really means that they will follow after Satan. And as I began to do my research, and the Lord began to reveal to me, Dan is the only tribe so far in the 12 tribe of Jacob that committed gross atrocity in idolatry. I mean, they're on top when it comes to idolatry. They've totally ignored God and forgotten about his standard, his status, and his precept. They've gone strictly in the way of Satan. And when God began to reveal this to me, that that descendant is in Haiti, so I thought, all right, Lord. So I went on Google and I began to read up on Haiti. Brothers and sisters, sorry, my hands are on my side. Brothers and sisters, when you have time, please go and read on Haiti, and you will understand what the Holy Spirit is saying. Haiti, national religion is voodoo. Brothers and sisters, I am telling you the truth. Just go on Google them, Google the people of Haiti, and you will see their national religion really is voodoo. So I said, oh Lord, you are so correct. Holy Spirit is so right. The tribe of Dan, it is. They are the Asian, the Haiti people back there in the Caribbean. So I have no doubt to disbelieve what God has said to me. Because so far, the Lord has shown me the tribe of Manasseh. And I've already did a video about that. They are like the Mexicans, the Natives, American, the Indian. And also with that tribe of Manasseh, there are also the aboriginals in Australia, and the Arawak Indians that used to live in America. So the tribe of Manasseh is quite huge. It's a massive tribe. I thought that the tribe of Judah was big, but Manasseh tribe is quite huge. So I just wanted to come to you and reveal this to you, that the tribe of Dan is living in Haiti. That's where the majority of them are. Some of them are pockets all over the world, just like the tribe of Judah in America. A majority of them are in America, but there are pockets, you know, in different parts of the world. So it's quite excited and very, very privileged that the Holy Spirit would reveal this to me. There is a reason why God is revealing who people are, and we shouldn't dismiss this, brothers and sisters. And back to the tribe of Dan. So when it says Dan have gone in the way of the serpent, which are the Asians, really, the Haiti people, God will bring them back. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. You're such a good God. Our God, Yah, Yeshua Mashiach, the King of Glory, is going to bring those people back, because the blessing from Abraham is on them. They are the descendants of Abraham. So God is going to bring these people back, because in the third part of the prophecy or the blessing that Abraham did on this tribe, say that, "Oh God, thou art my salvation." So in the end of days, they're gonna realize that that Yeshua, he is their true king. So it's quite exciting. I don't think people should get upset at me doing these videos concerning what God is revealing, because it's you know, at the end of the day, brothers and sisters, at the end of the day, no one will go to heaven with a lie in their heart. It just cannot happen. If you do not have the full truth of Jesus Christ, if you do not have the full truth of Yeshua HaMashiach, Yahweh, if you don't have his truth, you're not going anywhere except hell. So you have to come into total truth of Christ. The whole world is light, is laid in darkness. Lots of lies have been told, but God is revealing, because knowledge is going to and fro in the last day. We know that. We know that God has already declared that. So really and truly, I'm not really here to convince or convict anyone. That is not my job, but my job is to give the revelation, and then the Holy Spirit will do all the work. So it's quite exciting that we found the tribe of Dan. They are the Asian, the eight people. They are the one who really stole that. They're the first in the 12 tribe to commit gross adultery. I mean, Judah, Benjamin, the whole lot of this tribe, you know, our foreparents went into serious idolatry. Don't get me wrong. But Dan is, that tribe, I'm telling you, top the tops. And that's why they're not in the book of Revelation in the 144. There's a reason why God has taken them out. However, God will bring them back to the place where they're supposed to be. So I just wanted to share this beautiful revelation with you, my brothers and sisters. God eternally bless you. I love you all, and I will see you soon, someday in glory, in Jesus' precious holy name. Amen and amen. Amen. Blessings. Amen.